Why is there a box screwed to the bench?
So it didn't fall off.
What is that box?
It's a Altezza ECU box.
An Altezza ECU box? There happens to be a improvement here to the Altezza with a V8 engine attached to your Altezza computer box. What say you?
I say that improvement is pushing it.
You're trying to use the word subjective, aren't you?
Subjective.
That's the word you're looking for?
Subjective.
Yeah, that the vocabulary blank right there. So this one happens to be for Aaron. And Aaron is getting a Altezzalink ECU to run his early 1UZ.
That's not his 1UZ.
No, this isn't his 1UZ. This happens to be our 1UZ. But this happens to be his wiring loom, which you should know because you just made it. With coils. And is Aaron sanding these coils?
Pardon?
Is Aaron sanding these coils? You haven't done it, eh?
I haven't done it, no. It does, it didn't need to, it fits in this motor.
It fits in this motor?
It fits,
because these are Vvti coils.
So
they're these
are... Yaris, aren't they?
It's the same thing. Oh. Yaris, Vvti. So you'll see these coils just slide straight in. It's a firm fit. But if I take this coil, and I walk all the way over to Old Yeller, it doesn't fit. That's a Gen 1. That's a Gen 2.
Right.
And yes, I know it's got the fuel rails, but this is a Gen 2 engine. This is a Gen 1 intake manifold. They unbolt, they interchange. This is a Gen 2 throttle body. And you'll see it's got the Gen 2 breather, which is small. And the sub dampener assembly on the Gen 2 throttle body. So we've got coil unplugged. We've got some RX-8.
Oh, that's a tight fit, isn't it?
Injectors.
Oh, that's a tight fit.
Yep. The alternator wiring is part of the wiring loom, and Aaron's got a round alternator plug, which does not plug into this alternator. Funny enough. Because it's got an oval one on it.
It will if we plug.
Did you have an adapter?
I found one. I picked one up before I had it.
Oh, yeah.
It's somewhere.
Perfect.
I had this weird thought. Trying to get communications with the link. I think it's still inside the computer.
Yes, you will need to extract the box. Yes, the cable. You will need to extract the cable. This is the air temp sensor plug. We will put an air temp sensor on it. What say you, Poppy?
Hello.
She just wanders past, doing her own thing. Over the back here, we have a gearbox plug. It has got speed sensor, reverse lights, a power and an earth. We've got a starter motor plug. There'll be a little loom going into the starter motor. We've got four injectors on that side, four injectors on that side, four coils on that side, four coils on that side, which will all tuck underneath the factory covers because Aaron requested the Yaris coils, which have got to go underneath the covers. We're going to stretch the springs. I haven't stretched the springs yet. TPS, aftermarket idle speed control unit. Running down the front, there will be an extra plug here. There we go, a 6-pin plug, which will allow for oil pressure and oil temperature combo sensor if we want, so we can change some stuff around. You're walking around with a grinder, doing a wiring job.
Yep. Don't follow me.
I'm not going to follow you. So Jace has wired it all up. It'll plug into the factory plugs. This plug's got a whole lot of plugs, wires, and it hasn't one. Mm. What a waste of time that one is. And we are going to make some noise. We've got the fuel pump attached. We are going to make some noise with the engine, not with the grinder that he's trying to do.
There's a life.
There's a live what?
The blue one's alive.
Vroom vroom. Spears?
No, that's for the...
Cores and injectors?
Yeah. They haven't connected yet.
Good, okay. So, yeah, that's my stinky fuel. Yeah. So you've got temperatures. Temperatures kind of look good.
Yep.
TVS works.
Mm-hmm.
So it's still on semi-sequential. Oh, you've changed it to semi-sequential?
Changed it to semi-sequential.
And it's still unmodeled, and you've changed it to 4,000. Okay, yep. And so, under fuel heating... So basically, it's still an Altezza at the moment.
No, it's a...
It's a 4-litre Altezza.
It's a...
The settings are still Altezza, but it's...
So it's a...
The engine's configured as a 4-litre, but the tuning is a Altezza.
Well, it's got... No, well... So you got...
Have you turned off Vvti?
So we've got an 8-cylinder.
Yes. Have you put in the right firing order?
Oh...
1-3-4-2-2-4-4-4.
I don't think that's right.
I think that's fantastic, man. I think a 1-3-4-2-2-4-4-4 is really going to work well.
Yeah.
Probably want to put the right one in it.
What is the right one?
1-8-4-3-6-5-7-2.
1-8-4-3. That would be an interesting fire.
Yeah, I wouldn't know what I was doing. And then if you go to fuel heating.
Fuel setup.
And you go to injector setup. Injector setup.
440 cc's.
Cool. Yep. Good. And Aaron's, I see you've got it returnless. Aaron has taken off his fuel pressure reg, binned it.
Oh, so he's run the factory setup.
He's gonna run factory fuel pump, no return. And hence a fuel pressure sensor is gonna be handy for it. To ensure that it's actually got enough fuel pump.
It's still mine.
I don't know if he's put a bigger fuel pump in or not, but...
Well, for the 200,000 kk, I won't have enough fuel pump.
He may have done a fuel pump.
We may
have. Into the factory.
Let's hope he has, but we'll go on the fact that he has.
I can't remember, I can't keep up. Too many. Okay, so that's all good?
Rated fuel pressure?
Yep, that's all good.
It's all good?
Yep. Okay, and you want to copy some maps?
Yeah.
Okay, so open a G4 Plus on this case. Because I've got a really good one in G4 Plus, and we'll copy some maps across. We'll just bang some maps in, and then make it go vroom vroom.
G4 Plus? Now I've got to remember which one's the starter one.
So you've got power for coils, injectors, and...
Alternator and everything.
Oh, yep. What are the ones in this one? Oh, you got power on that one too? You have got power everywhere. Which, of course, Aaron doesn't need to do, he just needs to plug it in.
Yeah.
And confirm there's power at those points. Yep. Good.
You started making me wonder what these ones are for, but it should start.
You're trying to put a lot of faith in a little tiny wire. I think you'll find that wire's just not big enough, Jace. Okay? That's why I've got that great big wire that I use. I think it's lovely how you've run it through this plastic cover. Through the factory spark plug lead cover, it looks really very, very smart. Looks really good. And a good option with the Altezza fuel system, eh? To blank the regulator, fuel pressure reg.
Yep.
Makes it nice and simple. And nice heat-proof stuff going into that box, so it's why it's close to the exhaust, it's heat-proof. Air conditioning wire. We discussed oil pressure. Jason's going to make an alternator loom and a battery loom. you pop a bit more fuel up it, please? That's page up it. Just push page up. Because I just did the whole map. Just keep going. Give it a reason where. Yep. Cool. Take too long to get it to idle.
Yeah. Is this not working
or not? No, I don't think it's working.
Healthy.
I think what we'll do is we'll
have
some lunch and then we'll put a radiator on it.
Yeah.
We'll get it right up the top and we'll do a good setup on it. We'll do a proper setup. I'll give you a bit more demos on how to set it all up. Go through everything on it. Well done. But it's sounding okay there.
Have you got the alternator wiring?
Alright, we'll check it. We'll put the charge on it while you're having your lunch, eh?
Yep.
Put the big grunty charger on it. It's over there. Good stuff. How hot are we? Oh, I don't even know. We're getting low on fuel, too.
No. Lunch time.
With the change to G4X, I need my earmuffs too. We've taken a little bit of time just to reconfigure this one to suit. It's not going to go.
Oh, it's not attached to this end.
We might just put the trigger to the starter back in. Because this is a G4X and just a little bit different to everything we do, because everything we do is always a little different. Mm. We've taken a bit of time just to go through and do cold start. And just set it up, make a couple of changes to make it as good as possible before it goes on the engine. It'll still need a tweak once it goes on, but at least we're on the right track and moving forward. Ready?
Yep.
And of course on the vehicle, it plugs in. Drop some cold start out of it.
Take some cold start out of it.
Yeah, we'll take some cold start. Jumps good flames, Jace. It's quite noisy. Didn't take too long, got the idle. Considering this is the burnt valve.
Yeah.
It actually idles pretty good.
Oh, I think we're running out of fuel.
Oh, getting low on fuel?
Right. Yeah, the fuel pump doesn't sound very happy.
I think that's pretty good.
Call that good, eh?
I think we'll call that good.
You probably should talk to the people standing out there going, what the hell are you doing?
Ah, no, they're having fun. And then we've got that to go up to Aaron as well. Yep. So that's your gearbox and alternator and starter loop. Yeah, yep, they're all on their own.
Yep.
Perfect. I often get asked whether we do wiring. Clearly, we do wiring. And then I get asked things like, do I have a wiring loom for a 1UZ into a T100 truck pickup? What I do is we custom everything we make because everybody's job's different. Multiple different versions of UZ, from the thick rod, square rail, the round with cast rails, the VVTIs, 3UZ, big coil, 1UZ, small coil, 1UZ. Everything is custom. Left-hand drive, right-hand drive. So we custom make everything, like this one. And then we set it up to suit the customer to the customer's needs, either with standard ECU or with aftermarket. This is a really good choice for the Altezza because everything in the dash will work just like it should. It's been a little bit more of a challenge on this one because we did put the big injector. So again, there was a standard setup, but something a little bit different to, for us to work on and get sorted. Right, it's ready to go home. I'm not sure I've got all the instructions in here. Hope that's helpful. Talk to you again soon. Catch you later.